Welcome back to Side Emma. Munch. Munch, munch, munch. Munch, 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 munch. Too much munching. Didn't you? Yes. Assumed. So it was really Lex. So that's what happened. Yeah, honestly. Maybe your investigator instincts are coming back after the shock of this wore off. Reading this, I'm dead. Actually, not really. If everything went according to plan, they should have found a hut covered in my blood. fact that there was no body is no coincidence. Right, this is probably really confusing, so let me start from the top. S-I-N. So, when we visited Greenwell as Nick earlier, he had just been lambasted by Emma. So, we have plenty of places we can go. Absolutely. Yes. No, you can't. Absolutely. All right. Should be simple enough. That seems to be a serious face. You, the one who never moved on. That is kind of odd question as far as why would she just up and go after her friend was stabbed by her other friend? Alright, so I still... Victoria. And you weren't there. And that right there is his failing, isn't it? However good he might have been, was there any coming back from that? I guess we'll go to Reuben. I mean, up until now, we've had everyone saying he's the biggest asshole, and he didn't really seem like the biggest asshole. Seemed like he had more good points than bad, although I can understand him, being a little more full of himself and his work. Not being the best boyfriend. But that right there, that's not something you let go of easily. That's prime primo grudge material. Primo hate material. I can understand how after that, things just changed drastically. I mean, if he couldn't acknowledge. If he couldn't acknowledge how badly he fucked up, then... I half wonder if the contrast between Lucas and Lex isn't just Lucas is the comes across as a decent guy, but just wasn't there for wasn't there emotionally, while Lex did a lot of really disturbing things in spying on her and shit, but was there for her emotionally. He still skeeves me out. Oh, hey, Eve. Okay. Righto. Let me just sneak some food. Charming. Very rarely do. That's fair. Thank you. What? Not quite. Was it us, Nick? We were expecting to hear that from. But then again, we didn't even know that much going into that. I like it, Lex's theme, though. I don't know how I feel about Lex. I mean, he's a really interesting character, but I don't like him personally. On a personal level. As a character, he's really interesting. Yeah, neither do I. The what now? Through motive. Oh, okay. Well. Yeah, pretty much. But not in this case, yeah. Really? Elliot Thurston? Archaeologist. In business for himself, eh? But the FBI asked him. Well. Yeah, we're not sure. Fear that she was being tracked, so to speak. True enough, indeed. Yeah, genius. Yeah. With some funky fresh lies. Yes. Frightening. Still kind of skeevy. Okay. There's really only one place left to go. What is this? This the body that turned up? Let's go down the road. That body that turned up, that quote-unquote Adam told us about? Ah, speak of the devil. It's the last character with a unique sprite who still hasn't had any purpose in this case yet. I wonder who he could really be. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. Way too casually. No, edgy forensic noises today. Why makes you think? Ah, very good. Photo's really his. Badge is the real deal. Adam Donner Hug. Oh, so his real name is Adam. All right, what's your involvement? Oh. Never mind, he's not. Okay. It makes it curious what she was afraid of. Ah, against Lex. Oh. And that set her to leaving? Oh my. This is Thurston, the archaeologist? Oh shit. No shit. Oh boy. We're just spawning more topics here. Oh boy, we're spawning more topics. Knocked his daughter. Oh boy. Ah. Oh. traitor. Well, good. At least he was honest with me. Let's get out of here, first of all. Ah, now we can go to Thurston's home. Wasn't that just a damn thing? This place? Wow. You do it because of her, Oh. El Dorado. Search for El Dorado. It's true. I know what I saw. You're calling me crazy, but I found it, goddammit. The door to El Dorado. Covered in beautiful, glittering gold. Fortunately, it's just a damn door. Immovable. Tried everything. Also found unable to find any sort of mechanism to trigger it. The exception of one thing, a small indent on the floor, placed directly in front of the door. First I assumed it was just a crack formed over time. As I looked closer, I realized it's rather uniquely shaped. Then it hit me. The door needs a bloody key. How could I have been so blind? That's not all. Unlike the rest of the floor, covered in dust and dirt, the keyhole itself seems clean. Inclined to believe that someone had just had been there before me. Someone who took the key for themselves. There's only one person who fits that criteria. Professor Victoria Nova. Poor woman. Locked away like that. But also, poor me! I had no way of reaching her. Oh, yes. Even if I had, not like she could tell me anything. Did the only thing I could. I waited. Bought her house. I figured I could, in the meantime, continue her research. Perhaps she'd left some inclination that she knew of the key before? Years passed, and... Well, fortune smiles upon the patient. This referring to both me, for being patient, and our own little patient, Miss Nova. My condition had improved, and thanks to my little helper, the traitor, was able to secure a meeting with her. It went disastrously. Tried to be civil about it. Tried to even be giving. One had suffered 5 years locked up. No explanation as to why. I gave her one. I told her about the damn toxin. Then I asked kindly for the key. She wasn't surprised. She definitely knew what I was talking about. I didn't even have to drop the name of El Dorado. She simply looked me in the eyes and said, no. After years of waiting, a no! And worse yet, she's bloody disappeared. If her trail goes cold now, the key's gone. To make matters worse, I think the woman took me for a madman. I suppose I can only blame myself for that. I did certainly lose my composure. Honestly, though, that's not all I'm concerned about. I'm being reassured. Told it would be okay. That there's a solution to be found in this. And that's what concerns me the most. The tone in that voice. I'm frightened. I'm frightened I've taken this too far. I'm frightened that I've instilled an obsession worse than my own. That someone's going to die? I've read that part too, Miss Skye.